And welcome to the Icardo Center here in Bakersfield, California, for a special CSUB wrestling duel against number one Penn State on the Roadrunner Sports Network. I'm Corey Costello. Thanks so much for joining us on this Friday evening as a historical night for the number one team in the nation to be in Bakersfield as the Pac-12 Roadrunners are 3-1 in their dual competition this year. Meanwhile, Penn State coming in with 9 nationally ranked wrestlers. They are 2-0 on the season. Corey Costello with you. Thanks so much once again for being here as the starting lineups are being introduced. First, let's check out the CSUB Roadrunner starters as at 100, we'll actually start tonight at 133 pounds, but at 125, it's Sergio Mendez at 7-2 on the season. Carlos Herrera at 133 will start the action tonight at 6-5. Ian Nickel at 7-1 is ranked in one wrestling poll and as 32nd in the nation. Coleman Hamlin wrestles at 149, the redshirt sophomore out of Bakersfield, California. A.J. Fierro getting the opportunity at 157. He is 7-2 on the year. His brother, Adam Fierro, the number 12 ranked wrestler in the nation, at the 165 spot for the runners, is 4-0 on the year. Bryce Hammond, ranked number 8, Intermat, 6-1. The redshirt senior out of Bakersfield wrestles at 174. Jesus Ambris, the redshirt senior out of Vista, California, at 2-2, will wrestle at 184. And at 197, Ruben Franklin, the senior, 7-1, redshirt senior, 7-1 on the year. And at heavyweight will be Matt Williams, a redshirt sophomore out of Apple Valley, California. Let's check out the starting lineup for the Penn State Nittany Lions. Head coach is the legendary Cale Sanderson at 159-0 as a collegiate wrestler, 4 NCAA championships, and a Olympic gold medal as well. Nico Megalutis, the wrestler at 125. We will start again at 133 tonight. Jordan Conaway, the number 8 wrestler in the nation, at 2-0, comes in the 133 spot. 141 will be Jimmy Gulabon at 1-1 on the year, ranked number 2 on a recent poll. Meanwhile, Zane Rutherford, also number 2 ranked at the 149 spot. Nationally ranked Jason Nolf at 2-0, the redshirt freshman at 157. 165 will be Shakur Rashid at 1-1 on the year. Bo Nickel, nationally ranked out of Allen, Texas, the redshirt freshman at 174. Going to be a great matchup there with Bryce Hammond. Then Matt McCutcheon, the redshirt sophomore out of Apollo, Pennsylvania, at 184. Morgan McIntosh, number 1 wrestler at 197 in the nation, 2-0 on the year, will be taking on the 197 spot. And then it'll be Jan Johnson, the freshman out of Montana, Pennsylvania, wrestling at heavyweight for Penn State. So the Roadrunners come in. They are 3-1 in dual competition. They have competed quite a bit. They've had a couple open tournaments they've sent a few guys to. They hosted one as well. Roadrunners went 2-1 back in the Mountaineer duels in Boone, North Carolina, where they beat Garner Webb and Anderson. They did fall to Appalachian State. Very close on that one, 19-15. Recently coming off a 28-12 win over Cal Baptist at the Take It Outdoors meet in Riverside. They also had three individual titles, to be exact, at the Roadrunner Open in Fresno this past weekend. So very busy weekend for the Roadrunners. Penn State coming out to wrestle two duels. They'll take on Stanford, another Pac-12 team, coming up this weekend on their trip here out west. So a lot of good matches to pay attention to tonight. I'm really looking forward to the Bryce Hammond 174 match, the redshirt senior, and taking on Bo Nickel, who came in averaged at ranked at about 14 in one poll and a couple spots higher and a few others. That'll be a good match to watch. And then pay attention to the one they just introduced right there. That is Morgan McIntosh, number 1 of the nation, taking on a one Ruben Franklin. Both those guys, Southern California guys, and so they've met before. These two wrestled in high school in the Masters Championship, which was right before the California State Tournament when Ruben Franklin was a senior, along with Morgan McIntosh. They're the same age, and Ruben Franklin actually lost that one in a technical decision. So it's a rematch, I guess you could say, 5 years in the making, but that's a good one to pay attention to as well. And then, of course, 141, an interesting matchup. Ian Nickel, just outside the top 25 in the nation at 7-1, will be taking on Jimmy Gulabon at number 2 in the nation as well. So got a couple of intriguing matchups here. And really for the Roadrunners, head coach Mike Mendoza, who's coming to for the toss right now. Mike Mendoza talking earlier this week about the competition with Penn State, really just saying he saw it as just that. He saw it as competition, just more competition. Obviously, Penn State comes in with a huge pedigree, winning four out of the last five national championships. They've got plenty of national champions and plenty of nationally ranked wrestlers. But he said, really, he just has to view this, and the Roadrunners have to review this as competition and not prepare any differently for this competition, but prepare for this one like basically just flat-out competition that is in front of you. I know in practice this week they really talked about the conditioning of the Roadrunners since they have wrestled a little bit more than Penn State so far this year. I mean, there's a kind of a slight edge for Bakersfield in just the amount of activity that the runners have had. That could be good, that could be bad, but that was something that they talked about in practice on Thursday as they really focused on just knowing that these are the conditioning was a factor for them as well in this one. Andy Barth there on the flip in the USA wrestling jacket. He's bringing the world championships to Los Angeles. And a former wrestler at Columbia. Captains shaking hands, and we're about ready to go here at the Icardo Center. Again, we will start at 1:33 tonight. On the draw, that's what we came up with. It'll be Carlos Herrera, the freshman out of Bakersfield, against Jordan Conaway, the redshirt senior out of Abbottstown, Pennsylvania. Thanks so much for joining us either on Bakersfield.com or the Roadrunner Sports Network.
With these formalities out of the way, we're beginning our first match at 133 pounds.
And here we go as we are ready to go. Conaway and Herrera. Differing here as you got the experienced redshirt senior in Jordan Conaway. All-American last year, Conaway entered the NCAA tournament, seeded 11th. A couple big wins there, placed 8th to earn All-American status. Herrera on the season comes in 6-5. He's been very busy early on, and just a freshman, it's going to be no doubt the stiffest test that he has faced. As Herrera initiates the tie-up. And going for the single is Conaway. No advantage yet, and he will get the takedown. Good shot by Conaway there. He went for the double first, but settled for the single, and now takes control on the bottom there against Herrera. So a 2-0 lead for Conaway. And looking for the reversal as he nearly got some near fall there. The runners are a team. They're going to try some spins, going to try some rolls. They do that quite a bit, looking for the reversal. As Conaway looking for the back, and now here's Herrera looking for the escape. Conaway not letting up with that right leg, though. And Conaway looking to maintain control. And they'll continue with the control on the mat. Trying to work that left ankle and that, trying to get underneath, get that arm free of Herrera as he looks for the cross face there. Does have the arm pinned underneath as Herrera breaks the hold. And now trying to get for an escape again, but not going to happen. And now Herrera close to the near fall points, and he gets the escape. So Herrera gets his first point of the match. A lot of control time, though, for Conaway. And that'll do it for the first period. Choice goes to Conaway. He will take the down spot. And 2-1 with a lead there for Herrera. Herrera looking for, or Conaway looking for the escape. Conaway wrestled at 125 and he gets the escape there, and we're back to neutral. And a 3-1 lead now for Conaway. Not counting the riding time advantage either. As Herrera goes for the single leg shot, see if he can. Good sprawl by Conaway. He's not making that one easy as he reaches for the back leg, keeps a strong base. Conaway now spreading out. And now Conaway looks for the turn here, using the leverage provided by Herrera, who's holding onto that back leg. Now he's trying to get the post, and he will come up with a takedown there. So what a reversal by Conaway for the most part. I know it goes down as a takedown for Conaway, but that was sprawling on the shot of Herrera as Herrera tries one of those rolls, and now Herrera might get himself to the back, and now Herrera is looking for the pin. Herrera might come up with it. Wow, they didn't give runners any points. Herrera gets another escape. He nearly got some near fall points there, even though I don't think he had much control. That's why the referee not giving any near fall points to Herrera. He nearly pulled that one out. So 5-2 in favor of Conaway right now, not counting the riding advantage. And I think a little confidence here for the young Carlos Herrera and his match against an All-American, toughest competition he has seen. Herrera nearly gets the left arm and then picks the right leg, but a nice sprawling escape by Conaway. And now 2 seconds left, and that'll do it for the first or the second period. And now Herrera will go to the down position. He needs the escape points here or the reversal to try to get back into this match. Getting a lot of riding time for Conaway in the first period, not so much in the second. As Conaway taking the left leg away, and now he's looking for the near fall here. And again, Herrera trying to reverse it, but trying to keep that shoulder off the mat. It is not down yet. That left shoulder just off the mat. And now a quick turn by Conaway, trying to expose his shoulder, and it will be an escape here. But they're going to go 4 near fall points for Conaway. So 9-3 in favor of Penn State and Jordan Conaway. As here's a shot and not going to get there. Now we're going to have a takedown here for Conaway. So 11-3 as it gets into the major decision territory. Really would have been a heck of a benefit. Well, there's that 1 point there, so now it's just a 7-point lead. He probably would have, if he can keep it outside of a major decision, this is almost as good as a win for Herrera, as trying to avoid this shot from Conaway, but Conaway breaks down the right arm and comes up with another takedown. So now Conaway with a 13-4 lead and a 9-point lead here. Looking for the major decision for Penn State to give him the early lead. And 13-5 here as Conaway looks to shoot again. One more point for Herrera could just keep it a decision and not a major. And Herrera sprawling back here, and now no advantage yet, says the referee. And now they're going to give Conaway the 2 points. And so it will be an opening major decision for Penn State as they lead it. They're going to get the 4 points in the major decision, so it'll be a 4-0 lead for Penn State after the first match. Not a bad job by the youngster Carlos Herrera, though, seeing a All-American. So 4-0 Penn State in the duel here. Now a good matchup between Ian Nickel and a quick shot right away by Jimmy Goulibon. Nickel just outside the top 25 of the nation at 7-1. Goulibon ranked as high as 2 in some polls. As Goulibon will get credit for the takedown. And they will break the hold. So stalemate, and they'll go back to Ian Nickel on the mat here in the down position. And Nickel looking for the escape, trying to get that base, but Goulibon taking away the right, the left leg, and now Goulibon controlling, trying to take the left arm from Nickel as well. Goulibon, a fifth of the NCAAs last year, down number 10 and number 2 in the NCAA championships. Four-time state champion in Pennsylvania, 134-4 in his prep career. So Goulibon with the early lead, 2-0 over Ian Nickel. Nickel trying to keep the arm and now get away on the escape, and he does. Nicely done by Nickel. Goulibon ranked number 5 by Intermac currently, high as number 2 in some polls this year. As again, here's Nickel trying to turn Goulibon, holding on to the right ankle, and Nickel looking for the left leg from Goulibon. Side mount from Nickel, and now Nickel has got Goulibon on his back for just a moment, and Goulibon going to get a reversal. It will be a 2-point, a great move by Goulibon. Goes from nearly the near fall to control as on the edge of the mat, Goulibon got the side control over Ian Nickel as he works on the left arm a little bit. Nickel frees it up, trying to break the wrist hold. Minute left in the first period. 4-1, Penn State leading here. Goulibon over Nickel, and Penn State 4-0 in the duel over the Roadrunners now after the major decision by Conaway. So Nickel trying not to go, you know, if he crawls out here, he would get the stalling point himself as they're still in the active area. And now the hold goes out, and there we will go back to the middle. So 4-1, Goulibon leading Ian Nickel.
Senior Ian Nickel looking for an escape for the end of the period.
Nickel still on the bottom here with Goulibon taking control from the left side. He looks to break the wrist. Nickel trying to get a base, but Goulibon controlling that left leg, not allowing him much of anything. As Nickel widens the base to try to get a little bit of leverage. And so far, Goulibon will close out the first period, leading 4-1. So we go back to the middle. Choice goes to Goulibon, and he chooses neutral. So we will start neutral as a 4-1 lead for Goulibon over Nickel. Nickel tries to go for the left leg. Goulibon gets his left leg instead. And Nickel still trying to reach. And Nickel going to lose that left leg and still trying to hold on to the left leg of Goulibon. No control yet for either wrestler. Referee still no advantage, and now he's going to give the advantage to Goulibon. So it'll be another 2-point takedown for Goulibon. Nickel trying to now hold on for the reversal, and he's trying to break free, and we're going to have a stalemate. Stall warning on Goulibon. Ian Nickel for the Roadrunners. That was a warning there on Goulibon. Next one will be a penalty.
Minute 6 left here.
So here's Nickel trying to, again, score outside of that one escape is all he's had.
In favor of Mr.
Nickel was third at 133 in the Pac-12s last year. He qualified for the tournament for the first time, went 1-2. Wrapped up the season 24-11, four pins last year. He comes into today's match at 7-1 on the season. Redshirt sophomore, he also plays second in 141 of the Pac-12 championships. So looking for his first Pac-12 title, it's eluded him as a wrestler so far. Guluban not letting him get many points in this one so far as he's maintained control nearly this entire match. Side control for Penn State through these first two matches has been phenomenal. And obviously a lot of guys with some experience. I mean, Guluban, as I mentioned, 134-4 as a prep wrestler. Four-time state champion, fifth of the NCAAs last year. Another one of the All-Americans for the Nittany Lions. And the second period will end 6-1 in favor of Penn State. And Ian Nickel will stay up top on his choice. And Guluban looking for an arm early. Nickel looking for a breakdown and trying on that left knee. The base is good by Guluban as he tries to stand for the escape. Nickel will maintain. Now looking, got the left leg, looking for the right, trying to come up with the roll. He was able to get a near cradle earlier and did get Guluban briefly on his back, but not enough for control or any near fall points.
Minute 30 left here in the
Nickel still working on Guluban. Guluban, Nickel throws the crossface from the left side. Guluban breaks down, but not giving much up to Ian Nickel. Again, Nickel getting that crossface on the left side. Now he's trying for the half Nelson turn, and it's not going to happen again. Guluban just too strong and a touch of strong base. Early lead for Guluban, doesn't have to do much down here. 6-1 in favor of Guluban over Nickel. And now we're going to have a stalemate break with 59 seconds left in this one. So I see Nickel's thought process and taking the up position. He was looking for basically to break Guluban down as he was trying to simply hopefully get a pin.
I wish you would stand and be recognized.
And we'll have a false start warning on Guluban. So back to Ian Nickel, caution there. And now Guluban, quick stand-up and a nice escape. So fast, didn't hesitate there. He was so fast he had the caution the first time, but a great escape as it's now 7-1. As here's Nickel looking for something here. Not much Guluban has given him up as Nickel does have the left arm trying to fight for control as they come to the near edge of the mat. And they've tied up. Nickel trying to sprawls on the shot attempt. And all Guluban was doing was trying to break him down. And Guluban now might get another point here. And he'll say out, and there will be no points awarded there.
11 seconds left.
Guluban on top, 7-1, Penn State leading 4-0 in the duel and on the verge of a potential another major decision.
5 seconds.
As Nickel just trying to hold on and keep it a decision, and that will
be
the case.
So
Jimmy Guluban will get the victory for Penn State. And 3 points for Penn State as they lead it 7-0. And we will step away and take a quick break and be back with more here on the Roadrunner Sports Network.
Bakersfield Californian is a great read on the iPad. But did you know that the Bakersfield Californian is available on your Kindle Fire? Or how about Google's Nexus 7? The Nook? You bet. You can also read a full replica of the newspaper on your Android-powered smartphone, on Apple's iPhone, or on your laptop. We have a solution for any device. E-Edition is free for subscribers, or just $7.99 a month. The Bakersfield Californian. We're everywhere and anytime. Subscribe today. Bakersfield.com.
In a fertile valley, a growing university, with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community. A tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
And we're back here at the Icardo Center. CSUB and Penn State 7-0. Nittany Lions on top. A major decision for Conaway and a decision for Goulibon at 133 and then 141 respectively. And now we head to 149 where it'll be Coleman Hammond against Zane Rutherford. As here we go. Referee has him at neutral and back to it. Zane Rutherford, ranked number two by Intermat, beat his Virginia Tech opponent last week, 15-0, a Tech win there. So already Rutherford going to work, and he's going to get the takedown and control over Coleman Hammond. Hammond 6-3, the younger brother Bryce Hammond, and Rutherford just so short and quick and explosive in his moves, and already both leg control as now he tries to turn Coleman Hammond.
Rutherford, now a sophomore.
There's no wasted movement with these Nittany Lions, and of course that's definitely a tip of the cap to none of their program and their coach Cale Sanderson, but everything is so tight and with purpose, and now they'll go off the mat here. And so 2-0 is the lead in the match. 7-0 Penn State on top. You can see that score on the screen. We'll keep you updated of the individual match score here verbally. So 2-0 in favor of Rutherford. He redshirted last year. He was an All-American as a true freshman. And again, Hammond will get back over to his stomach, maybe. And here's Rutherford. Might have caught him. Rutherford looking for the pin, and he gets it. So in the first period with 1:43 to go, Zane Rutherford records the pin. And so it'll be a 6-point win for Rutherford, who had a quick night. And so Rutherford puts Penn State up 13-0. And now we move to 157 pounds, where A.J. Fierro and Jason Knopf will square off. And again, 2 points right off the bat. Knopf ranked number four by Intermat. His college debut, he's a redshirt, he's a sophomore, freshman eligible. Won his last match 4-1 on November 15th over Nick Bruschetta of Virginia Tech, who was number three in the nation at the time. He went 15-1 last year, wrestling unattached in open tournaments. He's got a 2-1 lead here. The escape point was given to A.J. Fierro.
4.5 great point average and won the Canadian.
So Fierro now sprawling on the shot attempt, and he'll keep him standing up for the moment. A.J., one of the four sets of brothers on this runners team, his brother Adam on the squad as well, not competing tonight.
By Rutherford, now leads 4-1.
Rutherford now up 4-1 here in the first period. Last year, A.J. Fierro, as a redshirt freshman, placed third at the Fresno City Music Open at 149. Six of the Roadrunner Open at 149 and was 13-11 with a pin last season. Redshirted in 13-14. Did win the 149 title at the Fresno City College U21 Open as another takedown by Nolf. And Nolf leads it 6-2 as they go back to neutral here, and the escape point for
Now leads 6-3.
Fierro.
Takedown. 59 seconds left here.
Nope won three state titles in high school at 103, 132, and 145. I want to talk about a weight jump. Talk about somebody who had a growth spurt. Went from 103 to 145 by the time he was done as he got a beautiful shot here. And he will nearly take control. Nothing yet, says the referee, as Fierro still grasping at the rear legs. And now there's the 2 points. So 8-3 in favor of Nolf. Nolf was 176-1 in high school. A.J. Fierro's prep career, Bakersfield High School, finished eighth as a senior at 145 pounds in the California State Tournament. Looking for the side control again for the... He looks to try to turn Fierro, and that will do it for the first period.
And at the end of one,
so Fierro trailing 8-3. And the choice will go to Nolf, and he will choose the down position. I have a caution on Nolf once again. Point of emphasis this year is they really want you to stay motionless. Beautiful escape by Nolf. And he's up 9-3. They really want you to remain motionless for that full second before the referee will blow the whistle. And so a couple times Penn State's been cautioned. Fierro tried to take the right leg and nearly cost himself a point. But Nolf able to sprawl back and avoid it. Nolf now tying up and taking Fierro down for the moment. Right leg shot attempt. Now he's looking for the double leg. Now he keeps the single, the right single. Trying to stand up with that base. Nolf has it wrapped around a midsection. And Nolf again as Fierro tries to turn. He's got him up, and Fierro trying to get control. Nolf picks the right ankle, but Fierro able to get it back for a moment. Great move by Nolf. And it'll be, well, Nolf nowhere to go right now as Fierro's got that right leg, and now they're going to call a stalemate there. Good idea by Fierro. Nolf, though, countered beautifully on two occasions. 9-3 in favor of Nolf. And he'll take the leg there and get the 2-0 lead. 11-3 as the second period is winding down, and we're getting close to a potential another major decision for Penn State. Fierro. Roadrunners in the first through the first three matches have yet to record a takedown of their own. They have a couple of escapes, and that's about it as far as points. No reversals yet either, or near fall points. Conaway got the major decision to start it off. Goulabon got the decision, and then Rutherford got the pin for Penn State, and that's where they got their 13 points. Again, control for Penn State. And that'll do it for the second period. So 13-4, Penn State with the lead in favor of Jason Nolf. 2-0 is in his college career, not counting that 15-1, of course, record in open tournaments last year, unattached. Here's Nolf now controlling the left arm of Fierro. I think the runners are really learning that against Penn State, as I mentioned earlier with Rutherford, there's not a lot of wasted movement. And so you've got to make sure you know what you want to do and execute it as quick as possible. As now Nolf looks for the shoulders of Fierro, lets him up for a moment just to try to turn him. And we'll have a 1-point escape here. So 13-5, Nolf with the lead. Looking for that single leg pick. He won't get it there. And now Fierro with the double shot. And that's going to be Nolf turning that his way, getting two more points. He's up 15-5. And now the 1 point reversal, or make that 1 point escape. And now Nolf looking for another shot, and he'll take another two takedown points. as 1 minute to go, 17-6 in favor of Penn State. And now he looks for the side cradle. But Fierro able to get up, another escape point for Fierro. So 17-7. Here's a double leg shot attempt by Nolf, and they'll go off the mat. 39 seconds left, 17-7 in favor of Jason Nolf. Coming up next, 165, Adam Fierro. AJ's brother, the older brother, and Shakir Rashid. Another couple points for Nolf. 21-9, our score here. We go back to neutral as Nolf tries another takedown there, and we'll have two more points. And we got another major decision coming our way here as Nolf looks for a quick pin late. Fierro will hold on here, and that will do it for this one. So 21-9. 24-9 will be the final on that one. And so Jason Nolf, another major decision. Actually, I'm sorry, technical decision, technical fall. First one of the night, so five more points for Penn State, and they lead it 18-0 as we roll right in to 165 pounds. Adam Fierro taking on Shakir Rashid. Rashid ranked 20 on the season. On one of the polls. There's seven. We try to use Intermat, but once in a while you throw one of the other ones in there. As already 2 points on the takedown for Rashid. Fairly a newcomer, a redshirt freshman. Last year going 4-1 in open tournaments with a pin. Two-time state champion as well. And the state of New York to Longwood High School, Coram, New York.
Four-time placer, two-time state.
So 2-0 with the early lead for Shakir Rashid. As Adam Fierro, the redshirt senior, out of Bakersfield.
Four-time placer is from Longwood High School in Coram, New York.
Looking, Fierro trying to find something to grab a hold of and set a base for a reversal, but not going to happen. Control.
Adam took his redshirt last year.
Still going to
had a remarkably good year.
Rashid. Still 2-0 Rashid
two
in favor
the
there.
Separate the two wrestlers. The extra 2 points, at least for the moment, belong to the redshirt freshman, Shakir Rashid.
So 2-0. So far, the closest match at this point I think we've had. As Fierro looking for that left leg, but he or right leg, I should say, of Rashid, but he won't get it.
Rashid picking up a lot of right down there.
Adam Fierro last year was injured and took some time off. Did qualify for the NCAA championship for the first time, but lost both matches. Was 18-11 last year with a pair of pins. Redshirted in 13-14, but was 22-3 that year in open competition at 165. So he's maintained that weight during his time in Bakersfield. Again, side control for the redshirt sophomore, redshirt freshman, Shakir Rashid. So 2-0 will be the end of the first period. Choice will go to Penn State, and Rashid will choose the down position.
Rashid chooses the down position, leading by two.
So Adam Fierro now, and we'll have a caution, I think, on Fierro, yeah.
Caution on the start.
Kind of came in with the right. It looks like he came in with the right arm originally, and then went back to his left.
As I say, you get a couple of those for free.
And looking nice. Nice sit by Rashid as he nearly gets the reversal. Good control, though, by Fierro. Rashid trying to set his base, and now the short sit. And Fierro trying to turn Rashid on the short sit and get to his back. Rashid, though, will be able to get up for the escape. That short sit can sometimes help, but it can be risky. Nearly for a second, Rashid exposed himself, but Fierro not able to take advantage. And Rashid turned it into an escape. So 3-0, Shakir Rashid on top here. Penn State leading it 18-0 in the duel. They've gone major decision, pin, and technical fall. As Fierro on the tie-up now. Looking for a leg, won't find anything yet. As now Rashid will go for the right leg. Fierro the sprawl back, trying to get underneath the arms of Rashid, potentially for the turn, but Rashid stays with it, sees it through, and comes down with another two-point takedown. Like Rashid's ability now as he controls both legs here, has the crossface sunk in from the right side for the moment. Now he works that arm of Fierro. Coming cross, trying to get the leg in the turn. Fierro trying to get a base, taken away again. Fierro now trying to
15 seconds left here in the second period.
Trying to base up from that left side, but both arms controlled now by Rashid. And that'll do it for the second period. 5-0, Shakir Rashid. And the choice will go to neutral. And Fierro down 5-0. Like I said, CSUB has yet to score a takedown so far. It's been all Nittany Lions in this one. This was one of the matches that really could have gone either way, but Rashid showing that he's got a promising career for Penn State ahead of him against a very good Adam Fierro. Fierro, a team state champion with Bakersfield High School, but best finish for him in the state of California was third. So 5-0, Shakir Rashid leads. Still at neutral from the start here in the third period. He tries to gain control of the arms now on the tie-up. And again, a quick attempt at a single leg thwarted by Rashid. And another attempted right pick. Right leg pick not going to happen. And they go back to neutral again. Both shooting simultaneously there. It turns into a lockup instead. 30 seconds left in the match and a 5-0 lead for Rashid. Looking for another decision for Penn State in this one. Goes for the single leg on the ankle pick. And Fierro, trying to avoid the late takedown, has his arms wrapped around the left leg. As Rashid has that left leg and trying to turn, and that will do it for this one. So 5-0 in favor of Shakir Rashid, picking up his second win of the year, now 2-1 on the season.
If you want to take a walk over here, they have opened up both sides of the bleachers. We want you to be
a great crowd on hand here at the Icardo Center today.
174 pounds.
As they have filled up the entire side. The cameras are shooting into what is the empty side of the building, but the entire side, camera side, is actually full. So they're actually allowing people now to go to the other side. So at least I would assume 2,000 in the house here tonight. So here's a great match. Looking forward to see this one. Bo Nickel and Bryce Hammond as Nickel at 174. Ranked number 8 in Intermat, and now we're going to have a stalemate. Bryce Hammond comes in ranked number 14. To make sure that number number 12 on the season, I'm sorry, Intermat. These two most likely going to see each other in the NCAA championships. Hammond, a two-time Pac-12 champion at 174. Injured last year, he couldn't defend his title, so he was looking for three. He comes up with two. And a great move by Nickel, and he will get the takedown. A great quick move for a 174. And Nickel has a 2-0 lead for Penn State. And now here's Hammond looking for the reversal. Nickel will lift him off the mat for the moment. Hammond tries the roll and nearly got caught. Decides to go back to the down position instead. Nickel quick there, trying to find the cradle. Not going to happen. Hammond looking to stand up. And again, Nickel breaks him down. Now coming across, looking for that left shoulder. Bryce Hammond, an impressive career at CSUB. As I mentioned, two Pac-12 championships. A state champion at Bakersfield High School. And now Hammond is in a bad spot. Nickel might be able to get on top, and Bryce Hammond is pinned. That is a surprise result for Bo Nickel as he pins the three-time state champion, pins the two-time state champion from California. So now on to 184, Jesus Ambrose taking on Matt McCutcheon, ranked number 10, or 14 by the latest Intermat, 2-0 on the year. Got a pin as well. So 27-0 Penn State with the lead in the duel. They've got two pins, a couple decisions, and a major decision and a tech fall.
Two very strong young men out there.
So a couple first. Matter of fact, both Hammonds, both Coleman and Bryce, pinned in the first round, first period today.
McCutcheon, a NCAA qualifier last season.
McCutcheon, ranked number 14 by Intermat, as we mentioned, coming off a victory. Meanwhile, Ambrose, 2-2 on the year, redshirt senior. So the 174 match expected to be a good one, and that wasn't the case. An easy pin as Bryce Hammond rarely finds himself in that situation. And now here's a takedown by McCutcheon as he takes control of Ambrose. Jesus Ambrose, the redshirt senior out of Vista, California. 3-4 last year in tournament competition. Made a dual debut in a 2-1 triple OT loss to Boise State.
Jerry Pierce was in the U.S. Air Force for 4 years.
Fifth at the state tournament at 189 as a senior, so he's cut a little bit in his college career. Control again for Penn State from the side as McCutcheon keeps control here for the Nittany Lions.
2 points up on McCutcheon.
184 last season was an NCAA qualifier. 1 win shy of an All-American spot. Was ranked 20th last year in the coaches' poll. 3-1, finished 4th in the Big Ten. 2-2 at the NCAA's, 1 win shy of the All-American spot. So 2-0. In favor of McCutcheon. Two-time PIAA finalist during his high school days, and potentially dangerous hold broken there. And so back to the down position for Ambrose.
I'm going to tell you a little story about Bill Varner.
So McCutcheon with the top position. I think we have another caution. Again, they really want the guys this year to be still for 1 second count. A lot of changes the last couple years in collegiate wrestling. Ambrose looking for the escape, and he will not get it, though. He couldn't get that right leg away. McCutcheon held on, and that'll do it for the first period. So 2-0, Penn State on top. As a choice, we'll go to McCutcheon. And McCutcheon will go on the down position. McCutcheon going to get away with the escape. He leads 3-0.
Well, I want to tell you that we'll try to do that in the break right after this. But we very much appreciate your
So here's the tie-up now with a 3-0 lead for Matt McCutcheon.
Every one of you, your service to this country.
2-0 on the season. As Ambrose now trying to avoid the single-leg takedown. Trying to turn into a double is McCutcheon as he continues to pivot. And great ankle control by McCutcheon. And a strong base as well. And then we're going to have a stalemate here. So back to the down position for Ambrose. And it'll be on the down position here.
It is truly a delight to see all of you here tonight. I think this is the largest crowd, at least in my memory.
As McCutcheon continues to get control.
And it is delightful to see all of you.
Looking for that right arm.
54 seconds.
Good control by Penn State again. 5-0, the lead for Matt McCutcheon. Over Ambrose, trying to get that right arm away as McCutcheon continues to control it, looking for a turn. He's able to set a post, and now he's trying to turn. 27 left in the second period. Arm control again of that right arm. McCutcheon gets that left hand there. It's a strong base. And a post, and he tries to pivot on that. Now he's looking for that second arm. Two pins already for Penn State. As McCutcheon gives up a leg for the moment, and now the arm, and that'll do it for the period, though. 5-0, Matt McCutcheon on top. Still to come, 197 heavyweight, and 125 will end the evening tonight. Neutral to start the third period, 5-0 in favor of McCutcheon. As I mentioned, CSUB is yet to even get a takedown in this one. As it's been all Penn State.
A little commercial advertisement time.
McCutcheon still in control. Have a quick break coming up after this match.
He sits down, winds himself down 7-1.
Well, it's 7-1 in favor of McCutcheon as
avoid a major decision of McCutcheon having riding time advantage.
Also, you got the riding time advantage being reminded by the public address announcer as well. And now we're going to have another takedown for McCutcheon leading 9-1.
Less than a minute left in the match.
And almost trying to allow Ambrose to get up, and now we will go back to center here. 50 seconds left in the match. Dominating performances so far for Penn State in every match. The closest one was the 5-0 victory. Gulabon's early one, I think, was the one of the closest, but that was about it.
Greater than 8 points, which results in an extra team point of 4 points.
So McCutcheon gets another leg, and McCutcheon again another takedown. And now the escape. And 11-3 lead now for Matt McCutcheon. 197, Reuben Franklin and Morgan McIntosh coming up after this, number one in the nation. Franklin 7-1, got caught in the Roadrunner Open this past week, losing that one via fall. So Matt McCutcheon will get the major decision as Penn State takes a 31-0 lead. We'll take a quick break here, and we'll be back with the 197 heavyweight and 125 matches back after this on the Roadrunner Sports Network.
Bakersfield Californian is a great read on the iPad, but did you know that the Bakersfield Californian is available on your Kindle Fire? Or how about Google's Nexus 7? The Nook? You bet. You can also read a full replica of the newspaper on your Android-powered smartphone, on Apple's iPhone, or on your laptop. We have a solution for any device. E-Edition is free for subscribers, or just $7.99 a month. The Bakersfield Californian. We're everywhere and anytime. Subscribe today. Bakersfield.com.
Introducing a new way to get the news. The Bakersfield Californian E-Edition. It's not a website, it's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your tablet computer, laptop, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, any place. Get your new Bakersfield Californian E-Edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
And we're back here at the Cardo Center. 197 as we've got the number one wrestler in the nation on the mat, Morgan McIntosh out of Santa Ana, California, and Reuben Franklin for the Roadrunners, ranked number 10, and McIntosh will record an early takedown. These two met in high school, both being Southern California natives, and it was McIntosh with the technical fall win. Technical decision over Reuben Franklin then, and he's out to a 2-0 lead now. Franklin coming off a rare loss for him this year. Got caught in the Roadrunner Open, got pinned by a fellow Pac-12 wrestler in Cal Poly. Referee going to caution himself on that start. Two-time All-American Morgan McIntosh. Looking for another title at 197 this year. Third place finisher last year, 6-1 in the NCAAs.
Really came on here in the last year. One of the toughest kids you are ever going to meet.
McIntosh, second is All-American, his third place finished last year. Lost in the quarterfinals, rebounded from that, placed third. Beat number 15, 13, 6-5, and defending champion, the number one seed. So still McIntosh in control. Franklin looking for something here as he tries to stand up, and he'll get the escape. And Franklin initiates the tie-up just like that. So 2-1 McIntosh over Franklin. This duel all Penn State so far. A couple major decisions, a technical decision, and Franklin almost looked like he tried to slip on the sprawl there, and we'll have another takedown by McIntosh. Another escape for Franklin and a nice ankle pick, but Franklin able to sprawl out of that one. And again, McIntosh trying to do it again. McIntosh ranked number one by Intermat in the nation. As Franklin now trying to initiate the tie-up here. Franklin's probably been the most aggressive of all CSUB wrestlers so far in terms of initiating some of the moves and even the tie-ups with Penn State. And now
Another leg for McIntosh, and Franklin trying to hold on to the ankle of McIntosh. No advantage yet, or points awarded for the takedown. As Ruben Franklin takes a hold of the left ankle. McIntosh has both legs, but still not getting control yet.
2 points.
Franklin now gets control to McIntosh. So 6-2, McIntosh with the lead here in the first period. Final 30 seconds of the period. As McIntosh with the left leg and side control for the moment, tries the half turn, and Franklin looking to sit, won't get that other leg out though. McIntosh has controlled it. As that'll do it for the first period.
And at the end of one,
so 6-2 at the end of the first period, McIntosh
Greg
on top.
Owens, the number one in the nation, Morgan McIntosh. He chooses the down position.
McIntosh, a California kid, was named National High School Wrestler of the Year by Intermat, won three state titles here in California, including a 189 crown in 2011, as nearly a takedown for Franklin, but
just want you to know, if Ruben did that to me, I wouldn't be getting up.
As McIntosh will get the escape.
So
McIntosh up top, 7-2. Franklin goes with a single leg shoot, and McIntosh able to sprawl back. So 7-2, McIntosh with the lead. All Penn State so far in the duel. As Franklin and McIntosh look to tie it up here in the center of the circle. As Franklin looks for something he can possibly pick and throw, and he found the leg for the moment, but a great counter by McIntosh to stay away from that. Still a 5-point lead for McIntosh as Franklin looking for an ankle pick. McIntosh, and now Franklin gets it. McIntosh so quick to turn, though. See if Franklin can keep the leg. And he's got 38 seconds, as now he's got the leg and the head. Oh, now on the arm. As Franklin trying to keep it. McIntosh doing the splits on the mat. And now he's almost got control. And now we've got the takedown for Ruben Franklin. That's the first takedown of the night for CSUB, and the crowd's excited to see that. So Ruben Franklin scores the first takedown points for CSUB. And it's a 7-4 lead for McIntosh, but this match is kind of living up to expectations. So caution on the start to Ruben Franklin. Redshirted last year, and he had a phenomenal redshirt year in his open tournaments. And an escape by McIntosh. And they kind of knew this would be a big year for Ruben Franklin.
5 seconds left in the second period.
And that will do it for the second period as it comes to an end there.
As we go to the third period.
And so we head to the third period, 8-4 in favor of McIntosh. 18-4 last year in duels was Ruben Franklin. So now they tie it up from the neutral spot. As a couple picks by Franklin. He caught McIntosh once.
I don't care what you say. Number one in the nation is quick.
And Franklin going to sprawl there as McIntosh shoots for the right leg. And Franklin trying to turn with that left ankle. Franklin's got the momentum. Franklin looking for the turn. Can Franklin turn McIntosh? 1:17 to go. Franklin trying to get that post between the legs. If he can turn McIntosh, he's got a little bit of exposure, and Franklin trying to turn McIntosh. Franklin, McIntosh is holding on for dear life, and now McIntosh breaks the hold for the moment. Franklin, though, still could set up a cradle here. McIntosh as he takes control of the right leg. And now they're going to call a stalemate there. But that was close. And now here's Franklin. And McIntosh tying it up again with 45 seconds left. The best match of the night so far in terms of competitiveness on both sides. Mostly he's been dominated by Penn State. But Reuben Franklin, as McIntosh will shoot Franklin, trying to set him up. McIntosh, though, holding on to the leg, and he'll take the 2 points there. And then the one-point escape, so 10-5. As they are tied up again, a shot for the single leg on the left, and they'll give two more points to McIntosh, who's now got a 7-point lead. And that will do it as he tries the switch, but it'll be a nice effort for Reuben Franklin. Morgan McIntosh, that'll go to Penn State on the decision. A major decision, so 4 for Penn State, leading at 35-0. But hey, for Reuben Franklin, the last time he faced McIntosh, he cut you on the technical decision. So here's to improvement for Reuben Franklin, and it nearly caught McIntosh on a turn. Those guys might meet again this year, I would assume, and the NCAA championships. On to heavyweight here, Matt Williams, the redshirt sophomore, wrestled at 1897 last year, was a Pac-12 finalist for the Roadrunners at 197, but moving up to heavyweight this year, knowing that Reuben Franklin would be wrestling back again at 197 after his redshirt, so he actually won the challenge match in the blue-gold meet at heavyweight. So a light heavyweight, no doubt, is Matt Williams. And so far on the season, Williams is 8-4 as he kind of goes through that growing spurt, giving up a little bit of size to some of his opponents. But pretty evenly matched here, looks like, with Jan Johnson, who's a true freshman out of Monton, Pennsylvania. So Williams, CSUB's hope for maybe their first win. Johnson got a 3-2 win against Lock Haven in a duel there. The redshirt walk-on for Penn State on the football team as well. Previously. His college debut came with that win at Lock Haven on November 13th. Trying to.
The referee says I've seen more action on my first dates.
Here's the. Trying to tie it up again. Looks like Johnson's trying to get the elbow of Williams. And they work near the edge of the mats. And that'll be nothing there. No takedown. As Johnson comes back to the middle here. Coach Sanderson on to check up on Johnson. I think we have a blood stoppage here.
Little blood time?
So blood stoppage here. Matt Williams and Jan Johnson. Scoreless here. Minute to go in the first period. For the Roadrunners, they'll be back in action. They'll be at the Cliff Keen Las Vegas Invite December 4th through 5th. A lot of top wrestlers in the nation at that one as well. And then they'll be taking on Stanford in Pac-12 competition on December the 17th. That one live on the Pac-12 network. Thank those of you for joining us today on the Roadrunner Sports Network. Our wrestling broadcast debut, as Williams might have a single leg. Can he hold on to it? Johnson trying to counter, and the crowd wants the points. The referee says not yet. And Williams still not with control as he cranks the right leg. Johnson reaching back to prevent it. Now he has Williams' arm. And Williams going to be off the mat. And we will go back to the middle. 20 seconds left in the first period. It'll be Williams tying up here with Johnson.
10 seconds left here on the
Penn State after this one will take on number 18 Stanford Sunday at 4 p.m. Runners see Penn State on December 17th on the Pac-12 Network. That'll be brought to you by a Real Television Network and Real Wrestling Announcers. We thank those of you for joining us tonight, though, here on the Roadrunner Sports Network. A student-produced broadcast and a old junior varsity wrestler bringing you the play-by-play tonight. So bear with me. I thank you for joining us. And so far, the largest audience we've seen on a Roadrunner Sports Network for the most part. So good feather in our cap, and no doubt a great Penn State following part of that. But thank you, and take it easy on us. We're rookies. Here's Williams on the top, trying to control and come up with some kind of points. His best case here, obviously, would be a near fall. As got a nice high control here. You might see a stalemate, though, coming from the referee. He's eyeing it very closely. Looking for the half. He can't quite get it in. Johnson not giving up much. And now here's Williams under both arms. Now Williams comes through, grabbing the wrist. So he tries to come under and turn. Now with the half, and now back to the wrist control. Matt Williams, as we mentioned, last season as a true freshman. And now we'll have our first point. A stall warning, and that'll be a point to CSUB, the 1-0 lead for Matt Williams. 49 seconds left. As Williams with the riding advantage, leading it 1-0. Williams, 27 left, trying to get underneath the arm and get to the head of Johnson. So probably some riding time points for Williams as well, as he got the 1 point. And another second stall point for Johnson. Now Williams lead by 2, not counting the riding time point. And so a 2-0 lead for CSUB over Matt Williams, or Matt Williams over Jan Johnson. So Williams will choose the down position here, knowing he's up by 2, doesn't want to give up the reversal or even the escape. Williams going to stand quickly, and the breaks the hold, and he has a 3-0 lead. So Johnson, the first Penn State wrestler to trail in this duel. And again, this was one of the matches that CSUB was eyeing as a potential victory for them. And they're a minute 38 from that. Again, Matt Williams, a true 197-pound wrestler. Finished second of the Pac-12 tournament. Lost to Oregon State's Cody Crawford in the finals. And Williams still trying to get around for a takedown. Won't get there, though. Johnson keeps the sheet clean. The Penn State yet to give up a tank down in this match either, and they go off the mat with 1:12 left. So Matt Williams back to center here. We go back to neutral. And Williams trying to take control. Looking for the cradle as he had the head and went down to pick the knee, but couldn't quite get there. 3-0 lead, though, for Williams. Potentially the first win for the Roadrunners. And back to 40 seconds left. Johnson ties him up. 30 seconds left.
30 seconds left there in the match.
Nice pick by Johnson on the ankle. And now Williams trying to turn him. Now Williams, 18 seconds left. Williams got to watch his back, though, as he's able to keep his shoulder off the mat as he's holding on. Johnson trying to turn. Williams is going to stay in control on the side. 5 seconds left, and the crowd knows that, hey, runners are going to win a match. Matt Williams winning at heavyweight. 3-0. Williams salutes the crowd, and great kid, great young man, Matt Williams. Nice win for the Roadrunners. So we'll end it as Penn State's got the duel in hand, obviously, but it'll be 125 Sergio Mendez against number 2 nationally ranked Nico Megalutis. So back to the 125 to start things off.
Nico.
As Nico Megalutis, excuse me, ranked 4th in the country, latest intermat.
He's up against a junior from our league of California.
And he's another California guy here for this Penn State team. Murraysville, Pennsylvania.
I'm sorry we didn't have more time to
my fault. 125.
Who have some impressive credentials on both sides.
Redshirting last season, didn't compete in any open tournaments either. So the 2-point takedown, and for the runners, it is Sergio Mendez, the junior out of Arleta, California.
Megalutis is a 3-time All-American. Was in the NCAA Finals twice, placed 3rd once. He is a true.
Goes back to Megalutis.
You get 2 very talented guys out there.
Escape for Mendez. Sergio Mendez looking for sprawling back on the shot attempt. 2-1, Megalutis in front of Mendez. And they go off the mat. I think they'll do a stall warning there on Mendez for going out. That's another area of kind of focus. They don't want you trying to jump out on purpose. And that was a warning there. Or pushing or pulling anyone off the mat. Mendez sprawls there. Megalutis shoots for the right leg. And they'll stay tied up here. Megalutis the reshot as he tries to turn. And he's got the right leg as he works it around. And still no control yet. Megalutis, though, holding on to the leg, and Mendez gets behind Megalutis. Mendez now trying to turn. Mendez, risky move there, and he almost gets caught himself. Saw what he was trying to do, but he exposed himself a little bit. So Megalutis with the score, and then an escape. So 4-2, Megalutis with the lead. As
51 seconds left here in the
first period coming to an end. 2 more points for Megalutis, 6-2. Megalutis on top, and now another escape. We're back to neutral here. 6-3, Megalutis. As they go out on the edge of the mat. So Mendez back to center. He'll go down. The down position here with 33 seconds left. And a caution on Megalutis. Sergio Mendez looks to try to stand up, but a great ankle control by Megalutis.
25 seconds.
Now Mendez.
Sergio looking to get out here before the
hold, end. Trying to hold on to an arm here.
Trailing by 5.
But it's going to be Megalutis holding on to control. Mendez now side control again from Megalutis. Mendez trying to stand up, and Went for the standing switch right at the buzzer. So 8-3, our score in favor of Megalutis. One win for the Roadrunners came in the last match. Matt Williams winning 3-0 over Johnson of Penn State in the heavyweight division. Standing up, and we'll have an escape here for Sergio Mendez. 8-4 now in favor of Megalutis. Good shot by Megalutis, and a great takedown there. And now Mendez exposing himself here as Megalutis going to basically let him up there. Escape 10-5. Megalutis with the lead. On the edge of the mat once again. And now he shoots on the right leg again. Mendez going up, looking for the ankle, trying to come up with the reversal. Still no control yet for Megalutis. And now there's a control. And it's 12-5 in favor of Megalutis. And now risky here for Mendez, getting close to exposing his back as Megalutis posts behind the neck and trying to turn from that left leg. And now he'll get him up on the escape. 12-6 Megalutis over Sergio Mendez, and they go off the mat near the benches. So 13-6 in favor of Megalutis. Single leg pick there, and we'll see if he comes up with the control. And he will. A takedown for Megalutis. 15-6 in favor of Megalutis. Looking for another major decision for Penn State. And we'll head to the third period. 35-3, the score in the duel. And Megalutis leading 15-6 in this match.
Advantage going the other way.
As Mendez giving up the reversal. And now 17-6. Missed a couple points on the scoreboard, so we 17-7, I think, now. Maybe they put too many points up. 14-6. And we're at 14-6 now. The referee at the table trying to figure out. I thought we were at 17-7. They'll go 16-7.
Okay, a little confusion about the score.
So 16-7
is
Megalutis on top, and
with a minute 50 left here in the match. This
we will go to neutral with 1:50 left. Final match of the duel. As Mendez avoids a tie-up for a moment. Now Megalutis.
Next match, remember, Cal Poly here at the Ancarta Center, 7 p.m. on January 8th. And hope to see you.
Going to get
there.
The right leg this time, and he's going to get the takedown points. So 18-7 as they break him as they go to the edge of the match. So another major decision looming here for Penn State. As recapping this one, a major for Conaway, a decision for Goulibon, a pin for Rutherford, a technical win for Nolf, a decision for Rashid, a pin for Nickel, a major for McCutcheon, a decision for McIntosh, and it was a CSUB decision for Williams. That's recapping this one. Looks like another major on tap.
for Megalutis and Penn State. 18-7 the lead here. And it'll be an escape with 38 seconds left for Mendez. 18-8. And a single leg going for a second shot. And that'll be a two-point takedown for Megalutis. That's a beautiful move for Megalutis. Turning that into a double leg. Unreal. 20-8 now in favor of Megalutis. And a reversal, 20-10. In favor of Mendez. 3 seconds and another reversal, and that will do it. 22-10 is the final in that one. It'll be a major decision, and so that will do it as the major goes to Penn State, and the final will be 39-3 in this duel. Penn State with the victory over CSU Bakersfield. So the Nittany Lions remain unbeaten on the season. They improved to 3-0. They will go to number 18 Stanford on Sunday. Meanwhile, Bakersfield will be at the Cliff Keene Invitational, then at number 18 Stanford on December 17th. Reno Tournament of Champions, Midlands Championships, not back here in Bakersfield until January the 8th. Folks, thanks so much for joining us today on the Roadrunner Sports Network and via Bakersfield.com as well. We appreciate it. Final today, Penn State 39, CSUB 3. Thanks so much once again. Have a great weekend. This has been Roadrunners Wrestling on the Roadrunner Sports Network.